Hello friends, in this video we will look at how to check if a particular software solution to the critical section problem satisfies the below requirements. So we have already looked at these requirements in the video about the critical section problem. I have already mentioned about these requirements. So in this video we are just going to look at like how to check if we have a software solution whether it satisfies mutual exclusion, progress and bounded weight. So I will not go into like details of these requirements. I have already explained them in the critical section problem video. I will attach that video in the description, link of the video in the description. And in this video we are going to look at some methods and tricks to easily check the above requirements. So let's first go into the mutual exclusion. How to check like if a software solution satisfies mutual exclusion or not. So the method or trick here is, so try making while statements. So while statements will be there in the entry section. Try to make them false for two processes A and B at the same time. So this is important. Try making them false at the same time. So if you can achieve this, so if you can make them false at the same time, the solution definitely violates the mutual exclusion principle. Okay, let's better understand this with an example. So this is our is particular software solution for critical section problem. We'll check if it violates the mutual exclusion principle or not. So here we have set flag A and flag B equal to false initially. Now this is the entry section and this is the exit section. So what I have said here is try so you are at this line. And this line, so this is A, this is B. At the same time, you are at and both these while statements. So try making this false at the same time. That means flag B equal to false. Your condition will be flag B equal to false and flag A also equal to false. Now try to think if this is possible. So is it possible that before entering this while flag B was false and before entering this while flag A was false? So if you look above, flag A is true here and flag B is true. So before entering this, flag A and flag B are true. So you cannot make both of them false, right? So you can make both of them true, but you cannot make both of them false. So this is that method here. So try to make them this false and then look above and see that whether before entering this while whether these both values can be false or not. If both can be false, then you surely are violating the mutual exclusion principle. Since if both are false, then both can enter it. But if any one of them is false, then it's good. You are not violating it. Okay, let's check another example also here. Again, both are false. But here I have reversed the while and the flag statements. Now just okay, try you are at this is A and this is B. At the same time you are at both the while and you are trying to make flag A and flag B as false. Just can we make it? So before entering this while, right, for if you see the value of flag B, right, okay, we don't know about the okay, before entering this, at least we know that flag A will be false, right? So either flag A will be false from here or flag A will be false from here, right? So before entering this while, we are sure that flag A will be equal to false. Similarly, before entering this while, we are sure that flag B will be false from here, or either if B would have entered once also, then also again, if when it wants to enter again, you would have said flag B equal to false. So here if you see, before entering, this is the condition mentioned, flag A equal to false and flag B equal to false. And we are able to make this, I mean, we are able to satisfy this, make both flag A and flag B false when both A and B are executing at the same time at these statements. So this totally violates the mutual exclusion principle. Since both are false, they both can now enter the here and they can enter the critical section. I hope that you would have understood the process or the method with these two examples. And if you have any doubt, do mention it in the comments. I will go to the progress requirement. So progress requirement is that, so if let's say there is no process executing in the critical section, and if some process wants to enter the critical section, then no other process should stop this process, which is, okay, let's explain this with some example. When A and B are there, and now no process is there in the critical section, and now let's say B wants to enter the critical section, then A should not stop B from entering the critical section. Okay, this is one definition of progress. But progress, you have to satisfy two requirements. One is this one that I have explained. Another is deadlock. So deadlock also prevents the progress, right? So if you have deadlock, then no process can enter the critical section, and that is also stopping the progress of the processes. So we are looking at the deadlock scenario here, and this scenario we will look at later. So, okay, how to check if there is deadlock or not in the software or code? So this is one of the trick. We will talk more about deadlock in later videos where we look at deadlock in details. So this is one of the trick. Try making while statements true for both the process at the same time. So in the mutual exclusion, we were trying to make both the statements false. So try here to make both of them true at the same time. If you can achieve this, deadlock exists. Another point to note here is that once your code is not violating the mutual exclusion, it won't have deadlock. Since you are able to enter into one of the critical sections, then of course you won't have deadlock there. Okay, let's take this example and understand this what I've written here. So try making this both of them true at the same time. That is flag B equal to true and flag equal to true. So before entering this is A and B. So what is the value? We are sure that before entering this while loop for A, flag A equal to true, right? This flag A equal to true. This is situation before entering process A while loop. And before process B, we know flag B equal to true. And what was the aim here? To make both of this and flag B and flag equal to true. And we see that if they are at same time here, then flag A and flag B are true. So you have deadlock here. Let's take another example. Initially both are false. Again, you want to make it true. But if you see if you want to make both of them true, then let's see the situation of flag A and flag B before entering these while loops. So flag A, at least before entering this, flag A is surely going to be false. Either from initial, if it is in your first time, flag A will be false. And if it has entered multiple times and it is trying to enter again also, flag A will be false. So flag A is false. What about flag B? So flag, if situation here is, flag B will always be false if it tries to enter here again, either from here or either from here. So flag B equal to false. But our aim was to make both of them true. So surely we cannot make both of them true here, right? So this violates the, so this does not violate the deadlock. So there is no deadlock here. I try to check here if it violates the mutual exclusion principle or not. Using the same logic I mentioned. You see here, both are false. So of course this will violate the mutual exclusion principle. Okay, the next one is progress with deadlock. So if you don't have deadlock, there can be situation where there is no progress. So I've already told about the situation there when I was explaining about deadlock scenario. Okay, let's try how to identify this. So what you do is let the process A first enter the critical section and come out. Now let A process sleep now. So once it has I mean, come out of the remainder section, let it sleep now. Now give two chance of opportunities to process B for entering the critical section. If it fails in any one of these, progress is violated. So progress without deadlock is violated. Okay, let's understand this with an example. So my first, so this is about it. So my first situation was, so you give one chance to, so this is, sorry, this is A, this is B, and this is the initial condition. Turn can be either A or B. So I've set it as A. Now give one chance to A. Okay, so that means turn was A, give one chance to A. So it will set turn equal to B, and after this, let it sleep. It does not want to enter the, it doesn't want to enter the section again. It is sleeping now. Now give two chance to process B, right? So now turn, turn is B, right? And A is sleeping now. Now B will try to enter this critical section twice. If when it tries to enter first, while turn not equal to B, it has to wait here, right? But turn equal to B, so it can go into the critical section. It goes into critical section, then it comes out, and now the turn is A. Okay, now for second time, after coming from A, it wants to enter the critical section again. Now when it tries, while turn not equal to B, right? So turn equal to A, so it will be stuck in this while loop, and now it cannot enter this critical section. Even when the A is sleeping, B cannot enter the critical section, right? So A does not want to enter the critical section, but B is also not able to enter the critical section, but B wants to, right? This is the difference. B wants to enter the critical section and A does not want to, but A is blocking the B, because I mean this turn is now A. Only when the A enters this critical section once, then only B can enter. So this violates this progress requirement. Okay, take another example. So here flag A and flag B are randomly assigned. It can be true and false. And this is the entry section, this is the exit section. Now to check whether progress without deadlock is violated or not here, right? So flag A and flag B, take any situation. Let's say both are true, right? Let's say both are true. So just give one chance to this A, right? So what it will do is, flag A equal to flag B, it will make flag equal to flag B. That means flag, so initially both were true. So again flag A equal to flag B will be equal to true after A has gone through this, and now this one A wants to sleep. It will give two chances to process B. In this situation, it won't be even able to enter this in the first chance itself, if you see. So it will check while flag A not equal to flag B. Sorry. But the situation is flag A equal to flag B, right? So I mean it will be stuck in this while loop forever. And A now does not want to enter into the critical section. I made the mistake here. So while flag A not equal to flag B, right? So while both are not equal, right? Here both are equal, right? So this situation, it won't be stuck in this while loop because both are true, right? So it will go inside, right? So I was wrong there. It will go here. Now it will set after this flag B equal to not of, so it will set false, and not of flag A is false, and still flag A is true. Now give second chance to B again. This time it will get stuck, right? Because while both are not equal, right? So it will be stuck in this while loop this time. And the second time it won't be able to go. So you are violating this principle again. And because A does not want to, but B who wants to enter the critical section cannot enter because of this situation. Only when both of them are again the same, then it can enter. So for that, A has to enter again once, then only B can enter, right? So okay, last one is the bounded wait. So in this let process, so bounded wait is like the starvation case. I'm not going to explain this, I already explained. So let process A enter the critical section first and come out, right? Let A again try to enter the critical section. So in this, give the first chance to A. So you can, you can do the opposite also, give the first chance to B and then apply it for A also, but I'm just taking one direction. You can also take the opposite direction also. Both should be a way to check it. And now let A again try to enter the critical section. Assume that when A is trying to execute the while loop second time, so when A is trying to enter the second time and it is in the while loop now, intersection while loop, and B is also then in this while loop at the same time now. Only difference is A is trying to enter, execute it second time. So it has already entered once the critical section, it is trying to enter again, and B is trying to enter first time. Now if A can again enter the critical section, there is a high chance it violates bounded weight. Okay, let's see this with an example. Flag A, flag will false, right? So okay, give first chance to process A, right? So what do you do? You do flag B equal to false, and now in the second attempt while trying to go, it is stuck in this while loop, and again B also is stuck at the same time here, right? Now let's check if A can go again in the critical section. So if already B is here, right? So it would have set flag B equal to true, right? And for this to go, flag B must be false. So that means A now cannot go into the, if both are trying, then A cannot go into the critical section. Only B can go, right? So that means B is not starved here, It's not that A is again getting the chance to go into critical section again and again. After A, B gets the chance. Once B will exit, again A will get the chance. So this satisfies the bounded wait condition. There is a bound on the waiting time. Let's take another example. Give one chance to A, and then A is again here, and B is already waiting in this, right? Now when both the while loop are executed at the same time, right? So flag B, right? So while flag B, so flag B is, since this is here, this is B, this is A. So since B is here, flag B is already, false here, right? So there is nothing preventing A from entering the critical section again, breaking this while loop again, right? So what can happen is, at the same time, both of them try to enter the, break this while loop. It can happen that A can continue to break this first and it will get the entry again and again. So there is nothing preventing A from entering again. So there is, in the previous case, if you see here, so this flag was preventing B from entering again when B was at this line while loop. But here is nothing preventing A from entering again and again. So here B, what can happen is B can starve here. So this was all I wanted to discuss about this, and I hope that these methods and tricks make it easier for you to check if some solutions are satisfying these three requirements. Now if you have understood this tricks or these methods, so now what you should do is, now you should look at the Peterson solution for critical section problem and see if using these methods can you satisfy all the three requirements. So we already know that Peterson solution satisfy all the three requirements. Now try to use these methods and see if you can apply these methods to check if the Peterson solution actually satisfies those requirements. So that's all for this video, and if you like this video, please subscribe to the channel and also like my video. Thank you.